I was born in 1961, and that was the year when we launched the first man in space. And his name was Yuri, and my parents called me after Yuri Gagarin. The baton, in a certain sense, was passed to us. The way we think about spaceship is that it should be very big, and it should have a lot of astronauts inside. And if you think about Star Wars or Star Trek, you have this huge machine which is traveling through the wormhole, but this is not the way it's going to happen. It is very clear. People are not made for interstellar travel. An insignificant speck of dust can basically destroy your ship. It will be a very, very long time, if ever, that people will travel to the nearby stars. But the robots, they can do it. In 1610, we found the first sign of somebody suggesting the way to get there. And incredibly enough, it's exactly the way we're planning to do it. And it was Galileo who received a letter from Kepler, who was saying that with the sails and heavenly winds, some brave souls will venture into this great vastness. People have been traveling using sails and wind for centuries. And it turns out that really the only conceivable way available to us today is pretty much going back and using the same principles, which is to have a solar sail and a very light spaceship, and to have a very powerful source of light to push the sail so that it will probably take 20 years to get to the nearest star, which is called Alpha Centauri. The beauty of that type of space exploration is that the most expensive piece of hardware is staying on the planet, which is this laser array, which is the size of roughly 1 by 1 kilometer. The actual spaceship is very cheap and very small and can be mass produced. It will be less than the cost of an iPhone to build one. And this will give you enough redundancy so that enough of them will make it there, and we will still be able to receive valuable information back. If we are able to overcome technical challenges, we could be launching it in the next 25 to 35 years, and then it will take another 20 years to reach the Alpha Centauri system, and then another 4 years to receive images back. The previous generation of space explorers have passed this baton to all of us to explore our solar system. Importantly, also venture into the galaxy and become truly galactic civilization.